It's Leo and the Bats.
Nice view.
I like it, but I prefer the one right in front of me.
Is that so?
Oh, yeah.
Do you mind if I quickly use the bathroom?
Sure, it's over there. I should clean up really quick.
Hello, my winged friend.
Told you can't come in here without being invited.
Leo invited me. Didn't you, Leo?
Aw, fiddlesticks. Mo, I have something very, very important I need to do. So you and Leo need to go play somewhere else.
This isn't a game.
Ha ha, very funny.
I don't think you heard what I said.
I'm sorry, you're right. That was a fake laugh. It wasn't that funny.
This isn't a game, Bats.
Potatoes, tomatoes.
Bats, you never listen to me.
Bats, just calm down and listen to Mo for a freaking second and I think we can get through this. Okay, fine. I'll listen. Tell me what's bothering you, Mo, and make it snappy. You have 10 seconds. Ready, go.
Imagine if back when everything shut down for the pandemic, you were all alone in your apartment. No roommates, no family, but you didn't care because your two best friends in the whole wide world live next door to you. You were excited because it was the chance for you to become closer with them. However, every time you try to hang out with them, they don't want to see you or interact with you or be your friend at all. All because of stupid COVID.
Hey guys, what you doing?
Mo, what the hell are you doing here?
Mo, you're not allowed in our apartment ever, all right? Never.
You guys want to hang out?
Can't risk getting COVID, bro.
Yeah, Mo, get out of here.
Well, you're all alone in your apartment. All you can hear through the wall is your two very best friends laughing and doing karaoke and watching movies and having a ball as friends without you. It's torture. You wish the pandemic would end, but COVID, just like Carrie Underwood's career, just won't go away. You try to understand why anyone listens to her music, but every time you try, you die a little inside.
I kind of like Carrie Underwood. Bats, shut up and listen. Fine. Okay, I'm listening.
As the weeks crawl by, you can't bear to listen to your two friends anymore. You have no choice but to tear them apart, so you devise a plan. I think it's Leo's turn to take out the trash again. This is perfect. Hey, Leo, buddy. You gotta turn on this live podcast with Julia Louise Dreyfus right now.
Leo, you didn't take the trash out last night.
Just give me a few minutes and I'll take it out.
Are you going to take it out or what?
Julia Louis-Dreyfus and Tony Hale are live streaming now, dude.
Excellent.
What is this mess? First of all, you were supposed to take out the trash, not me. And then you make a mess in the apartment. This is not acceptable.
Chill, amigo. I said I would do it. But like always, you keep volunteering to take it
and
out.
And like always, you don't do it, so why wind up doing it? It's not because I like it. And what are you watching?
Melrose Place.
Leo hasn't seen all of Melrose Place. What are you doing? What episode are you on? Isn't that before the whole Kimberly goes insane storyline? When you think she is dead, but she's actually alive?
I love that this is before the Kimberly goes insane storyline, because that just goes off the rails a bit, you know what I mean?
Wait, what do you mean? She is totally dead right now.
Well, after you realize that she's actually alive, isn't all f***ed up and murdery.
Bats, you just spoiled it for me. You spoiled it. You freaking bat asshole. You ass.
I'm an ass. You're an ass. You should have taken out the garbage.
Forget you. You've ruined 25 years of avoiding this show. F*** you, man.
Your plan begins to work.
I don't want to quarantine with you anymore.
And I don't want to quarantine with you either. I'm done.
Finally, after weeks of executing your plan, you see an opening. You finally have a chance to become a closer friend.
Hey, did you know that Walter White dies at the end of Breaking Bad?
No, I didn't, you f***ing asshole. I'm in the middle of Breaking Bad. That's it. I'm done with you. You gotta move out today.
Hey, Alfred, just so you know, if Bats calls, he is going to ask to stay with you. But I wanted to let you know, he has the virus. Hey, Daddy Bats, how's Bats doing? Oh, you didn't hear? He has COVID. Mario, yeah, he's got it. Donkey, I wanted to tell you first. Stan, yeah, He's sick, just where I wanted him, with nowhere else to go. As the final phase of your plan, you create an experimental COVID cocktail consisting of MTA handrail swabs, gum from a Midtown deli, and backwash from a scotch glass at a Trump hotel. It works. It infects you with COVID. You realize if your best friends have the virus too and recover, then the three of you can finally hang out without worry. For one friend, you put the cocktail in their favorite ice cream.
What the hell, dude?
The virus takes, but they are asymptomatic. The other friend, you conveniently find passed out in the hallway. When they wake, you feed them Spam laced with the cocktail.
I knew that Spam tasted funky.
In the process, you accidentally reinfect yourself. But it allows you and your buddy to go on a shared fever dream, unlike any other. While in your dream state, you and your friend have a threesome with a manatee.
Oh, dude, so gross. I thought it was pretty beautiful, actually.
When the fever dream comes down, you are excited to finally hang out with your best friends. But instead, they run off to the beach without even inviting you. You are upset. All of your efforts and hard work were in vain. Blinded by anger, you call in a hit to kill your two best friends. But the hit goes wrong. So you have no choice but to take matters into your own hands.
Mo, we aren't best friends.
What?
We were never even friends. You were always just a stupid, annoying, dumb neighbor.
What?
What Bat's meant to say is we just don't have a lot of people we call friends, you know? We just have really close acquaintances. Right, Bats? No. Yes, I think it is, Bats. Come on, Bats. Dude. Fine, yeah, that's what I meant to say. Leo's just my roommate.
Really?
Yeah, I don't have any friends at all.
Yeah, neither do I.
Oh, okay. Then I guess I really misread this relationship. You don't have any friends at all?
None whatsoever.
So it's not possible we could have been best friends anyway? Oh, laugh out loud. Oh, boy. Well, I feel like an oaf.
Are we cool?
Yeah, we're cool. Couldn't have been best friends. My bad.
Hey, everything okay in here?
Hey, babe. Everything's great.
Yeah, everything's just fine.
Hi, I'm Mo.
Hey, I'm Trini, but people call me Yellow.
Nice to meet you. I'm Leo and Bats' neighbor. Are you Bats' girlfriend?
No, she's just a friend.
Just a friend? Just a friend?
Bats, you freaking idiot.
Just a friend? Just a friend?
Oopsie.
Bats! I'm gonna kill you!
Ah! It's morphin' time. Yeah!
Anybody want a burger?
I'm starving.
What about Mo?
He's really, really dead. He's not going anywhere.
Okay, sure.
Yes, Shake Shack, and I definitely want a chocolate shake.
I could go for a cheeseburger and fries.
Hey, when we get back, can we watch Cobra Kai?
Yeah, I heard it's really good, and I haven't seen it, so don't spoil it.
Hey, I haven't seen it either. This'll be great. I hear it's like a sleeper, like you don't know what to expect, and then it's like actually really good. It looks.
I will remember you.
Hey, neighbor, what you doing?
Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you.
Wanted to be in a time war. So cool.
Remember the good times that we had. Let them slip away from us when things got bad. Clearly I first saw you smiling in the sun.
Found my wallet, guys.
It's Leo and the Bats. They're roommates, but they really don't spend time with each other until they're forced to in a pandemic. Let's see them interact, 'cause it's Leo and the Bats. It's Leo and the Bats.